Before getting into the supported platform for that, we have some use case validation specifically for data center interconnect at first. Campus will come later, but we have some caveats to talk about. First of all, there is no multicast in the solution yet. So no overlay multicast between fabric. No IPv6 yet, it's purely IPv4. There is no group-based policy as well for the first release of multifabric in 10.09. It will come later. We only support IBGP inside the fabric, so one autonomous system. So the multi-AS support inside one fabric is not yet supported. We support only external BGP between fabrics. So there is no support, let's say inside one, you may think I want to have only one internal BGP, one autonomous system between multiple fabric in local to the site. It's not supported. The notion of super spine, like a kind of hub for aggregating all the control plane BGP stations to one or two location that would be central to the one is not validated for 10.09. You cannot combine function of the border VTEP and a spine on the same switch. This is not validated. Okay. What I did in my example was a combination of the underlay circuits to the and the spine function, which is different. But here I'm talking about the border VTEP function and spine on the same switch, not supported in 10.09. This is really targeted for a symmetric IRB distributed L3 gateway. That is both for L2 and L3 connectivity, but it could be as well pure L2 VNI, L2 VXLAN between fabric. Okay, there is no support for a centralized layer 3 gateway in that model. One border VTEP must be used per fabric. So it means that we cannot share a border VTEP between fabric. And only one single border VTEP, so whatever it's a standalone or a VSX logical VTEP pair, only one can be used per fabric as well. So the reason for that is that we have no route type, no overlay ECMP, no route type 1 and 4 for L2 VNI data center interconnectivity. So pay attention on that. Only one border VTEP. So is it a standalone or is it a VSX again, a pair fabric? We do not support two consecutive inter-fabric VXLAN. Remember the blue VXLAN tunnel. We do not support more than blue inter-fabric VXLAN tunnel. So two consecutive inter VXLAN fabric tunnel is not are not supported. So it might work for layer 3 VNI, so I will show you in the demo, but it will not for sure work for L2 VNI. Pay attention that it's recommended to use the same layer 2 VNI setting, layer 3 VNI and the VRF across all the fabrics. So that's for the fabric in scope of the traffic, I mean. App suppression is supported for layer 3 VTEP. There will be no app suppression happening for pure layer 2 VNI solution. So the border VTEP, there is no any kind of in scope right now for a border VTEP that would have a static VXLAN tunnel and dynamic VXLAN tunnel. Okay, so pay attention that if you enable if you disable the split horizon rule for dynamically constructed VXLAN tunnels between the IBGP and the EBGP broadcast group, you will also disable split horizon for the static VXLAN tunnel. So you may create loop. So that's out of scope for the solution right now. Some additional point of attention. We do not support inter-fabric layer 3 VNI, so routing through the firewall. So that would require bidirectional policy-based routing to be set up. So for outgoing packet, that would be okay, but for returning packet, we would need to have, in order to match the right firewall, to have a kind of orchestration for that, and we do not have this. For inter-fabric pure layer 2 VNI solution with active-active firewall that would do layer 3, for instance, this is not supported because this would be considered as a MAC move. Remember that firewall MAC would be the same on the left and right DCs, so it would be a MAC move, so this is not supported. Some obvious prerequisites, so that's the MTU should be 50 bytes higher than the minimum frame that you have on your inner traffic. Pay attention, you will see that the routing for loopback is not as obvious as it seems to be. So avoid uncontrolled cross redistribution to avoid routing loop when you do OSPF to BGP and BGP to OSPF. The eBGP multi-hop command for EVPN address family, I talk about that, knowing that, again, those sessions do not follow the underlay connectivity. So that's why we have that multi-hop things that is between the loopback, and we focus on how to route the loopback. Route target, so we'll dive into that. You can guess that there are some route target for the EVPN route filtering that would apply locally. So that's generally what we have in the one single fabric. And then now we can define global scope. So that would be a local versus a global scope. The outbound route map, so pay attention if you are using a peer that is part of a peer group of, let's say, multiple address family, belonging to multiple address family, you cannot apply an outbound route map on that specific peer if it does belong to a peer group. So that's a small caveat, but... next is an existing solution for maintaining the next op that we see, that we will see in few slides. So that solution for the time being has a limitation in terms of scale, and we consider that we should improve it, so that would be subject of future.
So let's see now the supported CX switch platform for this new feature. So the route map, the EVPN route map inside the EVPN address family, it's available on the 6300, 6400, 8325, 8360, 8400, and 10,000. The next op self command as well available in the EVPN address family is available on the SEM plus the simulator. So that's for the control plane. For the data plane and the capability to bridge VXLAN tunnels dynamically between the internal BGP broadcast domain and the external BGP broadcast domain is available on 8325, 8360, and the 10,000. And next two lines here in light blue are the solution testing. So for that, we focus first on the border VTEP, where the 8325 and the 8360 are fully qualified. However, for the border leader, the one that make all the BGP sessions with the other sites, only the 8325 is qualified. The 8360 would be just for proof of concept with very limited scale, so not for operation. So let's see in terms of solution testing, and first with the border VTEP. So by solution testing, we mean that's a multi-dimensional scale that is validated. So for the border VTEP, as I mentioned, the 8360 and the 8325 are qualified with up to 64 standalone or logical VSX VTEP pair in the fabric. So 64 VTEP in the fabric. So now for specifically the border leader, the total number of sites that would represent the total number of VSX logical VTEP that we have across all the sites for the solution is 32. Likewise is the number of fabrics across all the sites that is also qualified with 32 fabrics across all the sites. So that could be, for instance, 30 fabrics inside one site and then two other sites with one fabric each. Then the total number of layer 3 routes across all the VRF for all the sites, including the host route, will be 22k. Then the overlay MAC and ARP across all the sites. So remember, we are not talking about ND because V6 is out of scope for the time being for the multi-fabric solution. And pay attention that on the 8325, you still have the limit of 32K as a unidimensional limit for the overlay neighbor. So with that in mind, we did some validation with some use cases where not all the VNIs are L2, some are L3 as well. So we have a total of 6,000 local MAC addresses, 6,000 local ARP entries, and remote site would be 18,000 MAC addresses and 10,000 remote ARP entries that we have. So that will be depending on what is L2 only, what is L2 and L3, and so on. The total number of VLAN local to one fabric was 512 VLANs, and among that that number of VLAN, we had up to 386 stretch VLAN, so extended VLAN among all the fabrics. So, for instance, in my solution example, that was VLAN 10 stretch between all the fabrics. And then for the VRF, we have up to 16 VRF among all the fabric. So that's a good summary of what we can have right now, the validated solution as the first release of 10.09.